Start recording. Welcome everyone, one and all, to tonight's live stream. Let's see, audio's rolling, dropped frame zero. Welcome, Denny. So, package arrived, awesome quality shipment from China. Yes, it arrived like this. And Tuxutku, welcome. Welcome everyone. Another time today. Let's see if this time is more popular. We can't stream so long anyway because my DC coupler here died already. It's a Chinese no-name one. So running from battery power. Anyway, so this awesome quality shipment. If you wonder why sometimes when you order something from Alibaba or eBay you don't get it, then it might be because packages on the way look like this. And this is another DC module here for ATX and stuff I had here. This one from, yes, this was also from eBay from China. This one arrived already in December or so, and I used this already. And as I said, I ordered this actually for my Spark build, for the Spark station. Over a year ago I already created my own ATX power connector to a Sun Spark Station IPX, and I wanted more than this because I thought another form factor is more ideal for this build. And also I have the ET4000 there. I was actually coding some vintage codes there for this acceleration bits and pieces, but they're not yet fully working. Welcome, Cobalt Ocelot. So let's unpack this. And this is already the second one because I ordered this together with this one on eBay on the same day actually. And this one arrived within 2 weeks. I think they had actually, by the way, shipping time 2 weeks to 6 weeks or something, slightly annoying. This one arrived, by the way, different sellers obviously, with a similar shipping time, Chinese Post or something. And this arrived from China to Berlin in 2 weeks, and this one not. And after 6 weeks or so, I complained there, hello, where's my parcel? And they said they sent it, and then they promised to send it a second time. And no, I already thought the second time it didn't arrive. So 6 months or 6 weeks later or so, this one arrived. So let's see what we got here. And with this open package, it's no surprises. First one got lost. And yeah, okay, let's hope something is still inside here. Okay, some cable we got, and apparently we are so lucky that at least something is inside here. What is this pressing? Oh, so maybe we shouldn't, by the way, drop it on our new awesome keyboard. What pressing, browsing, what turns current, whatever. So, cable, and okay, this is unfortunately much bigger than I thought. From the picture, I thought they are similar size. And there you see also this one. I suspect, I have not yet measured this, but this one, I guess, by the way, are we rolling this with full? I think this module, so what these modules are doing, they accept 12 volt from your car battery, solar panels, or DC power supply. And someone commented from this one, they need a higher input voltage because I was running it with, hello, can you focus? I was running this with 12 volt from my back lab power supply, and someone already commented I should have a higher voltage. But I suspect this very small modules, where not really much integrated circuits and capacitors are on the board, routes this 12 volt directly through. So you probably want to run this with 12 volt and not higher. And as much bigger as this module is, I would guess maybe they stabilize 12 volt also, but this is ridiculous. I really wonder if this is allowing for so much more power delivery if you really have a real graphic card in there. But so yeah, not really sure if I can use it for the Spark build I had in mind. Then let's plug this in and check if this works. And So, lesson learned. I should actually check the measurements and not trust some small photos. And this is already not going in very well here. And five people watching. How I can't press in a power supply here. So the question is, do we trust this to work on our 486 board, or maybe we do? So ground is, because I will use my lab power supply, so ground is the first one here. Or is it, or? This is a really ugly connector. I think I never had such a strange, ugly connector. So ground is the first one, so let's take this one. Ground was this one. Ground here. But in any case, even if it is a little bit large, this module, then I have another spare one. Maybe I use then the smaller one for the spark build after all. Ground there. So, and I have here a ATX to 80 adapter that we now plug in here like that. So does this look all right? Are we even having there anything in focus? So here, the fun of lab power supply embedded like setup. Then let's see what happens. 1.4 amps. So this board is the one that posts really slowly, which is obviously not ideal to test if something is working if you wait there. But we actually have post of our lovely 486 or 386 with actual 486 upgrade. I made a video about this half a year ago. So then this adapter works. Normally I would have actually measured this, but that is a little bit boring and slow for the live stream. Do I have the CF card in there? So another live stream with SGI keyboard, but I just realized today this is membrane. This is why this feels so ugly. And why does it not boot faster? Hello, CF card. Ah, actually, I forgot to plug in the CF card here. That obviously goes in here like that. And then for the Isar ET4000 acceleration stuff, the W32i here, that is unfortunately not as visible because backside of the PCB there, not as pretty as the other side. I already coded there some code, but it takes much longer to get working than the S3 PCI that I have done last year. So I have Cursor more or less working, hardware Cursor, although it's currently not drawn perfectly because I'm currently overwriting it with other pixel data. But this old-fashioned Isar stuff is really much more error-prone to get working, and also all the register stuff is more fragile and strange. And so ET4K W32. So this is how it currently looks like, and it looks so corrupted, which the corruption is okay. So this one is supposed actually to fill this with this X multiplied by Y pattern there. Only that currently we do not have linear addressing, so we only fill here 164K segment, and instead of filling the whole screen, we are currently wrapping here, hard clipping to the 64 segment, and this is data that actually should be here, overwriting it there. This is also the reason why we don't have a nice mouse cursor. Actually, I wrote the mouse cursor there, just that we overwrite it with other text data there. So you can trust me, however, that this mouse cursor would otherwise look okay if we would not overwrite this memory again. And one thing that is strange, so if we move the mouse cursor in this direction, this is all working all right. Only if we move it up, we get this strange bit pattern. I have a suspicion, though I don't understand why it doesn't happen if we move it into the X and Y increasing direction. But I guess this needs to wait for V-blank. Maybe we should only the vertical refresh. Maybe we should not modify the hardware registers there. Although it's actually not mentioned in the documentation, but this kind of things can often happen, this kind of sprite in second plane, and double buffering often is better to only flip while in vertical retrace. Though it could also be that it's still some bug, so I still don't quite see the point why this, if I move in this direction, you see it's absolutely not happening. So a little bit strange, but yeah, not that important. What is more important for me, what I'm writing out here is some register values, I hope at least, because I could not yet enable linear addressing. And first I was actually wondering, so let's see, sorry for this OBS crash, apparently running hardware isolated Git head is not the most reliable way to stream this here. Looks like maybe the stream started from scratch. Really annoying that restarting the stream starts here from scratch, but maybe I need to debug another day why this is crashing. Anyway, so the point of this is, what is this? Really annoying when OBS crashes. And so let's see here, the documentation is here. And the situation with this linear frame buffer is really strange. By the way, the code is this one. Let me double check here. We have the, can move the video over there, I guess. So the code is here, similar to the S3 code and such. Made here some documentation of register values, some symbolic values for debugging, and started to fill here acceleration function. And I do this, of course, this card is old, but this was just some personal project fun here. And I will not do all the old ISAR cards. I thought it's just one fun thing here. By the way, somehow this looks a little bit bending through here. And by the way, stuttering, maybe it was crashing then with Ethernet again. Yeah, this comes from link is down, link is up. So then maybe OBS crashed only. Or look at this. This is, do you see this? Yeah, it's on the string. So then this is here really TG3 instability. This is annoying. You would think this is some awesome quality server Ethernet chip, and then it has still with in 2019 with the latest Linux kernel stupid bugs. This is, yeah, TG3 transmit Q0 timed out. Thank you very much. So then it's not, maybe not directly OBS's fault. It's annoying. Each machine, then I guess I need to get an awesome AMD graphic card next for the Ryzen build. Anyway, so you see this is in general working proof of concept in one afternoon. And where is, by the way? By the way, you see here I noticed the energy savings. So this 486 DX266 is drawing 1.5 amps, which makes this 12 volt, so 12 watt plus a half, so this is 18 watts for the whole system here. And is it focused enough? And so because this is 12 volts multiplied by 1.5 amps, so 12 plus a half of this is 6 is 18. And when I run my program, because my program is calling the CPU halt instruction, this actually results in energy savings. So ET4KW32. So you see, although we do some graphic building, we draw here less amps, so 200 milliamps less. Just, and also the CPU on the DOS prompt, this CPU without airflow over it is getting really mighty hot. And with the halt instruction, even splitting some graphics and the halt instruction, the CPU after it cooled down from the DOS prompt is getting much more cool. And yeah, I wish I would after one afternoon have this acceleration stuff running. But so far, although maybe actually it could be that this points, because we right now we try one bit BLT, one copy operation here, but at least where, oh, here's my mouse, but at least the hardware cursor is, as I said, this would be the cursor if we would not overwrite it there with text, because right now we use cursor address, frame buffer address 0 for the cursor for testing, but certainly it obviously doesn't help if we overwrite the cursor with debug text. And yeah, evening Christian Iversen. And yeah, 0 drop frames here. Again, a pity that we have here. Each machine has some other. Either the Surface has stable Ethernet, but 2 cores less. This has quad core, but TG3 success is, by the way, really ridiculous. I would really. Anyway, so back to this point. So I found this BIOS is not allowing. By the way, maybe we move. What are we showing here? We show that. So this BIOS is not allowing us to use this VBA, VESA BIOS extension to program a linear frame buffer. And this is really strange here, this old-fashioned card. Here are some really strange notes for the address decoding. I actually already took the card out to take a look if this pins are even connected from, because the Ether bus has only 24 I think address lines, and I already took the card out to take a look if the address line 23 is even connected, and at least it's having a trace from the PCB. I've not measured where it's going to, but at least the pin is connected, because here is some really strange Ether port stuff, so I'm not really sure. I even downloaded here some really vintage X3 code from X33 somewhere here, and took a look here because I already thought this would not work at all. And here I found that actually they have here really something for Ether, because the new X3 has this code not anymore. So somewhere with X34 or something refactoring, they removed Ether code. But in this extremely old code, there is still some Ether stuff, and they have here exactly in the comments from 1991 or so, some comments showing exactly this address stuff here. Ether is address line 23 ZE, and here, because here this has some segment map comparator CRTC index 30, which is also what I found here in the documentation and was messing around with already myself, but this did not work immediately. Um, You mean, yeah, I said this in the initial stream, we can boot this also already. I switched off the lab power supply. I talk about this in a second again. So anyway, so because this is really strange, initially someone mentioned on the previous video when I unpacked this card that there is an ISA memory hole 15 to 16 megabyte, which from my history back 2 decades ago did not really remember, and actually it made sense. But I think it is not possible with this card to decode this into the 15th megabyte. Let me just find a spare terminal, like maybe this one, because I think you cannot decode all the bits required for 15 megabytes. This would be 15 multiplied by 24, and this would be in hex. Yes, I could use a calculator, but somehow often I find myself doing more advanced calculations, and then often this is more convenient than a calculator. So this would be F. These are too many bits, I think. So this would be 4 bits. And I think with the Etherbus thing here, you can only use 2 bits here. And even then, I'm not really sure if this really works, because here are some really strange other requirements of some SysW, disable, enable, system linear wiring. And I even measured this pin already. This is a pin. So anyway, coming back, so you have only 2 pins here for this, 2 address lines for the Etherbus, I think. And here's also here's some memory, image memory, what was IMA, image port, yeah, image port, as this was EM, genau, image, IMA, image port, whatever. This is some external video, for external video, something, encoding, decoding, if you add a TV tune or something. And so if this is image port enabled, this anyway does not support linear addressing, I think. So this only works if you disable this image port. And even then you have only 2 bits, because this matches what I see here in the old X3 driver. I hope it's on screen and we're not having drop frames. And this these 2 bits are this segment map comparator at index CRTC index 30 hex. So you have only 2 bits, and this make, what does this make? Not 15 megabytes. This allows a maximum of, this makes a maximum 2 bits. So this is basically, 2 bits is 3 hex, or does 3 hex shifted 22 bits, yeah, C. And this is in megabytes. This is, you can also use this. So this is, what is this, 12 or 8? This is 12 megabyte instead of 15. Because for 15 to use this memory, 15 megabyte memory address hole, we would need 4 address bits. Here, 15 megabyte, but we only have 2 bits to encode this. So we could probably only map this to 12 megabyte. So I'm not even sure if this works. So maybe this works if you have, right now I think I might have 8 megabytes installed there. So then it might work. Not really sure what the system controller there, a memory controller, is doing on the address bus. If you have memory there and you have an ISA card encoding to this address and memory, not sure what this then happens. Coming back to the question in the comments, so if you mean this pattern, object dir et4kw32, et4kw32, If you mean this pattern, so what I write there, I attempt to write for all x and y, write x multiplied by y, resulting in this nice test pattern. And the reason we only write into this area of video memory is because I have not yet figured out how to really enable this linear addressing mode on this ISA card. I never have done this in my life, and I already thought this might not even work, as strange as the documentation is written there. And only reading this X3 sources reassured me that it actually might work. So we only have one 64K segment here in this old-fashioned real mode address. Although I actually use protected mode, I use an unreal pointer for the ease of it. So actually we can address everything, but we have this old-fashioned VGA card mapped there at A0000, the standard VGA window, which means because we are using 640 by 480 with 8-bit colors, and this requires 300 something kilobyte of video memory or so. So we can only currently address partially into this. And the way this worked historically, the cards had some memory bank addressing switch and in the CRTC register. So you would to always in real mode write into this A000 VGA segment, you would then switch the VGA memory bank in this registers and then do this segmented addressing stuff. What I'm writing out here, because I fiddled around there way too long, I can also show you how the I forgot to actually swap the camera scene there. Sorry, I need to get more used to this. No, Christian, I didn't do it on purpose. I wanted to get this linear mode address working, and I wanted actually to map the... So this card has 1 megabyte, and I actually wanted to get this linear addressing working, and I actually tried to map this linear video memory to the 15 megabyte ISA memory address hole. And I was trial and erroring there for an hour or two, and it didn't work. And then I was reading this documentation back and forth, because you see here, is it on camera? I hope it's on camera. Because you see here in the documentation that this is actually all really tricky. By the way, I switch off this LED power supply just not to accidentally short something there. You know, this always happens for YouTube videos. You move something and then you have your ISA board in flames there. And so I wanted to fill the whole screen with this test pattern. And I can show you here, the loop for this is here for x equals here. Here is this. P is in C++ class, actually, because this is of course really funny that I run kind of sort of modern, this is latest GCC compiled with latest GCC on Linux as normal GCC assembler and C++ and assembler, and just with my or with other people's discovered tricks and my over the last 12 months polished glue code here, have here all the latest and greatest results here. So this P is actually a C++ class and is actually internally this unreal pointer where we shortly switch to protected mode and have a flat 32-bit, completely flat linear with a 20 gate enabled pointer to make our life easier. So to test this linear addressing, because we need to fiddle around there with register bits, with this W and image address port stuff disabled. And I was testing around here, so I wanted to fill the whole screen, just that it doesn't work yet. So this code is of course super simple. Just for Y, I could have coded this in one loop, but I could have just here for I equals 0 until as long as it is smaller than VGA height multiplied by VGA width. Ah, no, I cannot because I wanted this test pattern. So I need two loops. I actually need two loops because I want this just for the sake of it, that to see that the pixels appear in the right location and such. This is why I have two variables here, y and x. And we just set here with, this is the only inconvenience that it's not a completely regular pointer, but this C++ Unreal facade. So we have this set8 method with this Unreal pointer and set on each of this address for the whole VGA screen, just that this does not work yet. So I want to fill everything just that it doesn't work yet. And this is why this is currently wrapping to this VGA address window, because it obviously doesn't work yet. And yeah, so this is it. And I was poking here around already. Here is enablement, because this is also here. I hope it's big enough to read on the screen capture. So if we, because we do not get a physical address here from this video BIOS mode switching, and then I try to set it here to the 3 bits shifted, 3 bits, no, not 3 bits, 2 bits, 2 bits, 2 bits, 2 ones, 2 ones and 2 bits shifted 22 bits to the left. Ideally, I would want, as I said, I would want to use 4 bits, making this 15 megabyte, but we can't do it because the card silicon, the Tizen ET4000W32, does not implement this for ISA. And anyway, this does not yet work. We also, for this to work, we need to switch on here some bits. Some, this actually 3 bits, this one. Actually, for linear, we would need another one, because, but it didn't work, so I disabled this for now. This 3 bits here are for MMU, memory management unit, linear, and memory mapped IO. And we need memory map, we need to enable this MMU on this chip, and as well as memory mapped IO for the acceleration registers. Only with this MMIO bit turns on the acceleration, mapping the internal acceleration registers. And unfortunately, because this linear stuff does not yet work, also for this linear stuff, we need to disable this, as I said from the documentation, disable this IMA, this imaging port there. And because only with this disabled, we would have more than 1 megabyte linear addressing, but as I said, does not yet work. But I made this video, first of all, I wanted to test this, the second of this, also switch the camera scene. So I only wanted to live stream testing the second that is now hanging there in the air. DC board. It's also quite convenient actually to have this DC board there. Then I don't need an ATX power supply, and I have, normally I have this standing nicely there on the corner. It's of course slightly cluttered there, but having lab power supply in the corner for all your embedded development stuff I need and testing. And then the small DC board is actually quite neat for low power ATX and 80 stuff. This is why I have this. Just for your camera viewing pleasure, I have this standing here at the corner. And it's actually quite neat to see the power consumption and such as well. And yeah, then I need to do more tinkering, and also to show you that all this stuff. This is why working with emulators and virtual machines is quite handy, because with those I usually get things obviously working more quickly. If you write your own embedded stuff or operating system stuff, it is so much more quicker to get develop and test stuff in emulators like PCM, QEMU, DOSBox than with the real silicon. Because right now I also need to find a nice, if you know a nice software for networked file transfer. I have an ISA NE2000 card that we could use, or serial or parallel port. I have USB serial to USB to serial and parallel dongles also. So I need some nicer file transfer, because right now this plugging in the CF card, at least on this board, irritates the hardware, the IDE controller, in such a way that I need to power it off. So each time I test a new freshly compiled binary. I need to swap, not only swap the card right now, I also need to power cycle the board, because neither a soft reset with Control Alt Delete nor a hardware reset there on the pins makes the board come up again. It is stuck in initialization or something, and I need to power cycle it to boot again, which is slightly time consuming. So yeah, more bit fiddling is required. Of course, a little bit waste of time on this vintage hardware, but it is a nice hobby experience. And of course, it would be more productive to do reverse engineering on latest Nvidia cards for all the desktop people. But I don't really feel like helping Nvidia in the open source world. So I rather have my fun with vintage card. And no, I will also not buy more of those. So this will actually, I have one. I couldn't resist. I have one this time really cheap Weser Local Bus card coming, because if you follow all of my videos, you have seen that the last not that cheap Weser Local Bus card didn't work in the Weser Local Bus. I had there some serious graphic corruption with the BIOS coming up, some total screen corruption. But I think the other card is not completely dead, because you can make out parts of the characters on the screen. You can watch this Weser Local Bus experience video. So this is really the last card. I will not buy another Weser Local Bus card, more than two I do not want to have. Not really sure if it's a board issue or a card issue. This is why for €9 I try this, but I will not buy more. I will also not buy more Isar cards, obviously, because for some of these Isar cards, like this one, was really not cheap. This one was €50, I think. In the last video I actually said more than 30, I looked it up, this was actually €50, quite expensive. For €50 you get a decent entry-level AMD card, actually, of course, really funny. But again, I wanted to have private, personally, hobby fun with one of the first graphic accelerators, and it's an interesting learning experience here to have this experience of getting this up and running. And I hope I don't spend too much more time than one more afternoon. And what I need to do next, so actually I can start this once more, because what I print out there is, right now I do not have, as I said, I do not have this linear memory running. And what I have hopefully running right now is some really strange setup, because with these bits there you can change different memory mapping of this card. And where was this? There was somewhere. You see here all these tables of possible memory mapping configurations. And because right now we need to get away with this 64K segments, let me just try to find, this is A00. And by the way, this is, I've run this through our OCR kit for text recognition. Original, this document was just a scanned version, didn't have text recognition. And so now run through OCR kit for some text recognition. We can also find stuff here more convenient in it. And these are the possible video memory maps of this card. And depending on how you set these registers here, you see that you have here this VGA memory segment, because this card has this MMU, this memory management unit, where you can, do we have this here visible in, somewhere was a nice diagram, but it was further away. So what I currently try to do, because I wanted to have this acceleration stuff working, and for this I try to get away with this stupid 64K segments. And what we need is, we need this memory mapped registers. These are these accelerator registers where we write this X and Y and destination address and stuff like this. And then the accelerator internally will do the bit BLT, the line drawing and such. So we need a configuration with this accelerator registers mapped, so we only can use any of those here. Okay, this is a Firefox, because text direction anyway, so any of starting of those. And then here you see this star is either with IMA port enabled or disabled. We don't need it anyway, because we don't have an external image port access stuff anyway. So this is usually we want this with disabled, and then what I tried to do here is I wanted the normal VGA memory at the regular A0 address just for easier debugging. So this would be this option, or I think only this option. So we would need this AMC bits. You see here AMC bits 2 to 0, or 0 to 2 if you read it from right to left. And this AMC bits are this here. It's slightly strangely written, because they have here then bit 3, 5 and 4. They are slightly unordered here. Need to be always careful with such bit designations like this. And what this means are these different bits in the CRTC. CRTC is a cathode ray tube controller that all VGA cards have. So we have here register 36, bit 3, 5 and 4, and this bit stand what I showed you earlier here. No, this is not my code, this is the X3 driver, the old one. So these are, do we have this on screen here? Was not even shown the screen capture. Need to monitor this more. So these are the bits that I wrote here. 101 is what we wanted to have here. This is why it's hard to read, because this is reversed here. This is 354, so you need to shuffle this around in your brain, unfortunately. Those bits, as I said, stand for MMU enabled, memory mapped registers enabled, and system linear memory mapping. And you see this bit was bit 4 here in the center. And this is disabled, because it is also slightly strange anyway, because this is linear mode enabled. Somehow it is not indicating here memory mapped registers, I think, which is, or is it? Anyway, so this old ISA card is really a little bit hard to work with all these quirks and stuff. And what I print out here, I wanted to show that I try to debug this here with some printouts. Good old printf, ET4K W32. And these values here are registers. These are here the accelerator registers, and I think this should probably make sense. I try to make sense of these bit patterns, and I think they could potentially be the right bits there. So I think changing these registers there had some effect here in this memory mapped enable and bits like this. So yeah, but this is where I'm currently stuck. This linear mapping didn't come up and didn't work. And the accelerator, then I try to program the accelerator, and this looks similar to the S3. This is not so different. Bit BLT is this. And this looks similar to the S3. We compute here some strides that we need to fill into the registers there. And then we write P is our protected mode pointer thing. IO base is right now, I set the IO base not to the linear address, but relative to the A00 address to index into this, because then actually it is mapping here. You see A00, and then the memory mapped registers live here at BF, which is the second text mode, because B8 and such is this CGA, EGA text mode stuff. And then you have in this address range the memory mapped registers. Slightly tricky, but there you see you can even with 64K segments in real mode have accelerated graphics, line drawing, bit BLT and such, just that, of course, like sprites in the Commodore 64 where you were poking just some 64K of address range. And of course similar here, just that you don't have it at some nicely separated memory mapped I/O range, just in the middle of the text mode or graphic mode address range here. So you have them mapped at BFF00, and I compute this offset here somewhere at the beginning. This is not my code. Maybe I close this that I don't always show the XORG driver. Here's our code. So that is here. So IO base is BFF00, and we sub, because our flat protected mode pointer is, I load this to, instead of the linear address 12 or 15 megabyte, whatever we could use, I set this right now to A0000 for the regular VGA range, and to index this based from this address relative to the memory mapped IO registers, I computed this offset to use this flat pointer that is addressing A0000 there, and blit. So these are the things that you always need to keep in mind, that you cannot just, if you have one pointer that you have to A0000 there, then obviously if you want to address relative from this, you obviously need to compute a new relative base based on that. Otherwise, if you just use this address, you have this offset additionally, then you always need to keep such details in mind. But again, this is slightly tricky here in this vintage setup here with all this quirks and strange segmentation stuff here. No idea, by the way, why they have done this. They have the bits here for more, was it 6-0 or what was it even? I have completely no idea why they have done this like this. Where is it either? Or this is really strange limitation that I do not really understand why they have done it. This was this W. Let's see if we find it quickly with this W. Where is this disabled sprite? Somewhere was segment. Where was it written here? This pins, you see already address line 22. By the way, maybe I switch this off, not to accidentally short there something. To either bus 22 bits here. This is directly connected, and then they write here node LA. This is a either bus address line 23 should be directly connected to seg E, which is some segment enable or something. And then where is this other? System linear wiring. No, come on, where was it written? Somewhere we had it on the screen earlier already. Let's see, 16-bit address, blah blah blah. W32I, 16-bit address, blah blah blah. Eight to 16-bit only, either bus, blah blah, see next. Maybe here. So what was this? So you also see if this image port is enabled, then you have this high address bits go directly to this IMA port. So you need to have this disabled. As you see, here's image port enable 0, only then you have this encoded to the real address lines, otherwise you have this encoded to the image port there. But where was it written with this two upper bits? See, so A, here you see this image port enabled in this configuration must be connected. So this ISA bus ports 19 to 17 must be connected to address ports 19 to 17, and A22 to 20 inputs are redefined for the image port. So yeah, there you have that. But where was this strange higher bits? By the way, here is, note that EBIO should be low so that W32ID codes A23 to 15 into C00. Anyway, where is, here you see with this segment CRTC index register 30 bits 0 and 1 are compared with SEC-E and A22. Yeah, I think this is exactly this. So this is exactly what I found out already, and also matches with this old XOC driver X33 from 20 years ago, that this only allows for 2 bits, because so this programmable comparator only has those 2 bits, and this actually has 4 bits. I have completely no idea why they did not implement it so that this comparator compares all the 4 last bits for the ISA port, because for VESA local bus, I think it compares all. Anyway, so only these 2 bits are used and allows, if system linear mode is disabled, these bits must be low. To allow memory, says if system linear mode is enabled, A21 and A20 are address inputs. If the image port is enabled, A22 to 20 are ignored for address or comparison purposes. So yeah, really, I have read this already for 1 hour back and forth, and it's still not yet working. It's really a little bit strangely worded and hard to follow. And anyway, so this is when you have documentations, but you read it 5 times and still don't understand which of the 2 bits go nowhere, and does it work or does it not work. MTCP seems to support MS-DOS 6, and up, would that work? MTCP? Yeah, I would need to test this another day. The reason I'm still swapping this CF card back and forth, because I'm more interested to get this to work and get file transfer set up. But if someone has an amazing idea or knows already what works, please let me know. Would be really nice if I could just update something there from DOS. Anyway, so this is really frustrating that this are only 2 bits and somehow doesn't yet work. Even micro channel, so this also supported micro channel if you should have one of those rare IBM PS2 with micro channel. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed this quick unboxing and ET4000 W32i update. I could try to do some live coding here. So what right now, we have 2 challenges. I could also, because right now I wonder if I had there some bits reversed, we could theoretically try some light live coding that was linear addressing. Not sure if I mixed there some bits actually, but I think I tried this. So linear, we could re-enable this. Right now I at least did not, this code is running. So this are 3 bits, 3 bits, not 3 bits, I always say 3 bits, but this is incorrect. These are 2 bits. So this is because with Lua running here, I can always double check here, just cut and paste here some code that is often similar enough from C to Lua to evaluate. So these are 12 megabyte, supposedly. Can double check dividing this by. So exactly 12 megabyte. That matches, I think, with what I saw in the X3 driver. We can also pretty print this here to hex. This is C. This C0000 matches with the X33 driver, I think. So this reassures me because I already thought this does not work, and only because I unpacked this old X3 driver, I think it could maybe potentially work. And this AMC needs to be then 111, standing for MMU, linear, and MMIO, supposedly. And then we have this AMC bits are shifted. AMC is this here. And as I said, this is slightly unsorted here. This is 2, 3, 4. This is, you need to read this slightly differently. I have also no idea why they have sorted this so strangely here. They could have just, because this AMC is only used in this table. So if they would have just defined this AMC there slightly differently, it would be in order with the bits in the register. So because this starts from bit 3, we need to shift it 3 to the left. And also, just for the completeness, end this existing bits away. And right now this has no effect, but if we would use, like I had it a second ago, with 0 in the middle, we would need to end this bit away just in case. So this is why I leave it there with this bit mask. This bit mask also shifted 3 and inverted. And then we also need to program this system segment map comparator. As I said, this only compares 22 bits of this 24 bits. The last two bits are in this comparator. Comparator. How to pronounce it in English? So comparator. So this is a segment address comparator, and this are CRT index register 30, bits 0 to 2. So by the way, the question is, because you always need to read this so carefully with only half of the bits used, are compared with MADE 24, A23 and 24 inputs to allow memory access. If system linear mode is disabled, then inputs must also be low to allow memory access. If system linear mode is enabled, A21 and A20 are address inputs. So which bits did they say are used for this? Or we check with the old XORG driver. Here is, you see either bus bits 1, so here's index register 30 system segment map comparator. Bits are compared to the host upper address bus or decode and are not used to select video memory. Either bus bits 0 and 1 compare to SEC-E and, okay, they write here the it sounds like the first bit, so bit either bus. Bit is also slightly not perfectly written in my opinion. Bit 0 and 1, so this first bits. The rest is reserved here anyway, so this is reserved. Bits 5 to 7 are reserved, usually left to be 0. 0 to 4 are addressing mode, meaning this comparator. So bit 0 and 1, I think, so this bits, I think, and there you see, I think they could use more of these bits for the higher decode on the ISA bus, but whatever. Compare SEC-E and So this effectively means address line 23 and 22, as far as I understood this, meaning the first 2 bits of this register. So we shift this, we have 24 bits here that we could use, we shift this, yeah, this looks correct. So we write the higher 2 bits, which are 1-1 there in binary, hex 3 or decimal 3. So this should also work, and then better disable this image, external image port that we don't need anyway. And also this mapping there, wonder if. So you see quite many bits need to come together just for this linear addressing to actually work, and this map is actually this map index there. It's always best to use a more advanced PDF viewer where you can have bookmarks, because otherwise you search for this again and again. This is index 6, I think. Yeah, memory map here. And control mapping of the frame buffer. Bits 2 and 3 should be 0 if this bit is set to linear system mapping mode. And we had this nice table, was it called ADC or ACD? The problem is also, let's find this again. So this would be all bits here, so then we have, so this should probably be this line. All these AMC bits we have set to 1. And then this star here, this asterisk, is IMA, this image port enabled or disabled. So disabled is 2 stars, so this should be this. And then our memory mapped registers should be at 3FFF relative to the, at the end of this address range. So yeah, quite complicated bit stuff, and if just for the vintage fun, it's of course a little bit excessive time spending wise on this vintage card here. Let's plug in our CF card, compile this, and let's double check. We also need to update, by the way, for the fun of it, we could make 2 tests. So right now, actually, okay, this, I think they said this should be 0, right? Yeah, they should, because then I should make this here u int. I usually make this const for the compiler to hopefully inline this fully or make constant propagation. Const u int 8 map, and this should be 0 now, but right now we have this to 1 for our um, 64K VGA window, because then we can symbolically code this like this. And for the fun, I leave, or do we update this already? Physical. Now let's see if this works, because here we rebase, this is a function, a method of our unreal pointer to rebase this to the newly, to rebase our offset of this unreal pointer, because my unreal pointer class has a base, so that we can, for example, for the frame buffer access, access all the frame buffer pixels starting with zero and not with this 12 megabytes that we would have otherwise, just as convenient. So this method is internally storing this offset for the Unreal pointer access. So if we do not get with this set, if we do not get any test pattern, our linear, oh, by the way, do we turn on the A20 gate? Ah, yeah, we turn on the A20 gate. Maybe another video, I should make a video about the A20 gate. This was also fun stuff. So let's save this. This is compiled. Then do I have somewhere a terminal where I am root? The problem is if I explain all the details, then it always takes forever. Do I not have a... Do I really need to enter my root password again in front of... Ah, here's root. Mount SDD1. So this should be that. So because I now set the bit so that we should enable this linear frame buffer, which so far didn't work, and I enabled this flat 32-bit flat protected mode pointer to index into the linear 12 megabyte address range. If we do not get a test pattern, then we did not enable this linear mode correctly, or it doesn't work with this ISAC card or whatever. Overkill is the only way to go. Spend a whole weekend writing a code generator to piece together AMD5 function from binary patterns only to save 1.2k. Best way to spend time. Yes, I agree. Also, I could tell some fun stuff, a story from business office accounting overhead nonsense of today. I have currently two time-wasting inquiry nonsense going on where I answer administrative office email where I also think, is it really worth to spend 20 emails for maybe selling some commercial software licenses that are not fulfilling? And by the way, I cannot say this often enough. I started this YouTube channel to have some fun here and do some fun stuff, because when I spend half of the time with administrative office nonsense, where at the end of the day we don't even earn something because people only get on my nerves with 20 stupid emails, then at the end of the day I'm also not happy. So it can, what I want to say, long story short, is it can make you more happy to spend some hours on vintage ISA stuff than writing 20 business emails and only think how irritated are some people that they write such emails and get on people's nerves with such kind of stuff, and the end also have nothing from that. So we have some ACL timeout. That is interesting. That means that at least I have not seen this yet, so this is live on YouTube just for this live stream, just for you. Do we, by the way, have zero drop frames? Amazing. So this, I have not seen this. This is the acceleration stuff that is trying to reset the accelerator. This means that actually this function has some effect and works, because right now we are obviously not writing into the correct memory. So right now we have only, by the way, why does this ACL timeout appear on the correct location? That is interesting. Because I use print. This is using a BIOS call, I think. This also means that waiting for the accelerator engine to become idle could potentially work. But you see, now we don't have this test pattern anymore. because I modified the code obviously to enable this linear addressing, which doesn't work. And then we don't have this visual pattern on the screen because it's obviously ending not in the graphic memory. And yeah, this is the fun stuff. You have there some table and some bits, and they don't do what they are. Either I do not write the bits to the correct location, or the bits simply do not do what they are supposed to do. And then you spend hours hunting each bit and then also recounting. For example, let's, by the way, disable this again. So let's disable this, because right now I'm slightly more interested to get this accelerator engine to do something. Then we also need to modify this map again, and then, because this map was 1 for this value, this is this here, this map value 1 for having the VGA memory mapped at A00, and this accelerator memory mapped registers mapped to AF, oh no, wrong, to here, this is the map value there, map value 1 for memory mapped registers at BFF00. And because this means that theoretically this code that is waiting for the accelerator engine to become idle has some effect, because right before I have not seen this print statement, and because we get this print statement, I would think that at least we are probably poking around there in the correct memory mapped registers of that. Unused, what is here now? Map, semicolon, missing. So, and then I have the setup here that doesn't exist because CF card not in there. I could optimize this slightly. We could theoretically compile this as root. Yeah, then we need to. Read the partition table that UDEV and such creates a device node again. And yeah, with this you spend hours hunting and counting each of those bits until you eventually find the one bit missing that is preventing this linear addressing stuff to work. And actually, because I already recounted all the bits there and compared them with the specification, I already thought, okay, fine, then maybe this linear map at 12 megabyte with this ISA card does not work. But because I saw this in the old X3 driver, I think in the meantime it has a chance to work. So yeah, then you hunt these bits again and again and count them again and step and debug and printf through all of the stuff over and over again. And yeah, then an hour goes by and another hour and object dir. By the way, I was wondering, did I dirp? Oh no, okay. AT4K W32. Now we should probably have this bit pattern, and because we do not get accelerator engine printout there, I think we are probably poking the correct accelerator registers. And this, by the way, are this memory mapped. These are the control registers for the MMU. And this is here the accelerator status, and yeah, as we are not getting, by the way, we could also comment out, because I was thinking that this pixel was not there earlier, so I wonder if actually we might, one pixel is not a lot, but let's ET4K, let's comment this out in the split function and let's see if we get there a slightly different picture. But then I will end the live stream and try to let's double check. I compiled already. Because I think it's not fun to stream here 1 or 2 hours of error, trial and error, compiling and swapping CF card and stuff like this. And ideally, of course, very few people probably will use this. Oh, it's not on screen. Very few people will probably use this ET4000W32. It's really rare or rarish. By the way, the fun thing is I was monitoring two cards of those in America, in the USA, but they were expensive. I think the 1 megabyte version in the USA costed $89, and there was a rare 2 megabyte either version. They wanted over $100 for this, and obviously I didn't buy it for this price. And only when a 50 euro something card in Germany appeared, I bought this for 50 something plus shipping. So, and funny, after my video, this card in the USA sold. So I wonder if someone who was watching my video actually purchased for $89 this ISA card in the USA. If you are the one who purchased this, let me know in the comments below. That would be really interesting to know. And this is, by the way, just like the, what is his name, a YouTuber, the LGR, Lazy Games Review. And stuff like this, always when, and Techmoan also, always when they make videos and the eBay prices go up, because stuff want, the 100,000 people who watch this stuff want it then. So let's see, is there one or, oh no, there are also pixels and unfortunately that's not affecting that there. So yeah, there you see the trial and error of this. I now need to get out of here, get some dinner, and will continue another day or night. And the reason, to finish my previous paragraph, the reason I even mess with this at all is, first of all, I was really interested in this because back in the day we only had this cheap OR card, and back in the day I did not even know that there exists accelerators with sprites or such, because I thought VGA is VGA, and I thought all VGA are the simple memory mapped frame buffer thing, and it could not even come to my mind that there are VGA cards with more features and functions. And just for my hobby fun and sake, I want to mess with this now. And also I want to document this. There is, now I found actually the old X33 drivers, so actually there are some bits and pieces, but there's also some Allegra or Allegra library and DOS library or something. And even in this Allegra, Allegro something, also known under some other names, some VBE acceleration stuff. And even there, they do not have acceleration code for this ET4000W32. So, and also it is, if the open source community back in the day, 20 years ago, I thought we in the open source community were always proud that all this vintage stuff would work, and you could even in 10-year-old machine install Linux and everything would work, when in Windows you wouldn't have drivers anymore. And I find this really slightly sad that we allowed all this once working drivers to bitrot in such a way. It would, this cards, this are just some thousands lines of code. It is really a pity that we let this bitrot, otherwise we would still have today's XORG drivers. Yes, very few people would want to use this ISA card, but there's also a PCI card and stuff like this. It's really a pity that we constantly every other year had to break APIs and ABIs, that this code was eventually deleted because it wasn't compiling and stuff. And I thought, of course, my microkernel is still far away. I have not started with new public code for this. And this is just the first steps to document, to live stream here and live code here and stuff like this. And also educational, to show you how this looks in the documentation and how you work with this kind of registers and stuff and debug around and trial and error and how to get it working. And what I would want to do ideally is to have some repository. Of course, I alone will not do this for all cards, but I have done this with the S3 Verge, which is working for this. Of course, not everything, not complete, but even with 3D triangles and of course not complete and not error-free, but just as a start. And ideally, I would want to have for some outstanding cards like this, one of the very first 2D ISO accelerators, the S3 Verge. Eventually, if I find a not too expensive one on eBay, because I never had one, 3DFX Voodoo, just for the fun of it. And then also with a modern ATI and first NVIDIA also, maybe even PS3 NVIDIA RSX, just for the fun of it or something. And have there, at least for those cards, a reference implementation of readable, nicely formatted modern code. And of course then also a microkernel. Of course, in the beginning, just a kernel. I have already example code for this, just switching into protected mode and doing your own direct memory stuff with interrupts and graphic cards like this and Ethernet and sound card and stuff. So we will eventually have here nice collections of videos for low-level tinkering on DOS and later your own kernel and maybe even Spark. So maybe in a year or something, when I have some skeleton of simple microkernel, maybe we port this to boot this on some Spark and MIPS that we could do eventually. But this is in the future. The next days we will also do other light programming and documentation and streaming, and maybe even for the fun of it, I will do a Sunday stream of playing X-Wing on such cards, on such vintage machine, some vintage YouTube Live retro gaming for the fun of it, and fun stuff like this. So I will not bore you each day with vintage ISA cards, just that this is currently my latest toy and trying to get this to work. So I hope you enjoyed this bit fiddling documentation live stream. A pity that this TG3 card, TG3 Ethernet thing in the Mac Mini crashed again. Somehow this is a recurring thing here that initially, but the funny thing is I had this Mac Mini running the whole day, and the whole day with light Ethernet work, it did not crash, and as soon as I started live streaming, it crashed again. So yeah, but somehow it's a recurring theme with this Mac Mini, with this TG3, that it with some initial packet burst, the firmware or driver gets irritated. Question is, which did I miss? Welcome, Devin V. Glad I made it to the stream. Yes, welcome. Hope you enjoyed it a little bit. Also, not that successful vintage bit fiddling today. How are you enjoying the new keyboard? I'm enjoying it very much. The only pity is that when I have it connected to the USB hub in the display, then I can't easily plug it in and out for the vintage fun of it. But by the way, I have not tested it with this PS2 there. For the fun of it, I could pull it out here. So this now the thing is, I might need a second keyboard now, not to have this. Where's the adapter now? Here's the adapter still laying around. I only tested it with PS2 on the Octane, so let's plug it in here into the. This is of course also getting slightly long now, this adapter. Hello, is this even? Why is this going in there? So am I pressing it in wrong or? No, it should be. Why is this? It's crazy hard to press in there. Why? It's of course PS2 to AT, so, but my god, why is this? It's really hardly going in there for some reason. I mean, at least I have two or three of these adapters that I never used in some adapter dongle box. So then this looks connected. Let's see what we get. And then we call it a day. Hope I don't burn my new keyboard through. I haven't seen the AD. I haven't seen an A. But although I haven't seen an AT connector. Well, you mean never? Or is it the first time today you have seen an AT connector? Or is this... I think it works because we can control. So the first time, yeah, and it works first time on this vintage to show you a nicer blinking. We have here fast VGA. So this is some slightly isolated 4 bytes at a time VGA copy that works for to some degree. Maybe not fully. Actually, I earlier messed with the code. Maybe I destroyed the code, so I need to double check all the time. But yeah, so then this works. Just don't have games, or this is a CF card. I don't have so much on the CF card, not even a demo, but yeah, so now we tested this, and let's switch this off. So then this is also tested. And 80 is this. Let's focus here on this amazing. And this is also, I didn't have to buy this. I had this in our, by the way, the funny thing is, I probably in 20 or 30 years never used this adapter. I have even no idea where I got it from. This was just in my drawer. So really thankful that I didn't have to buy new stock of this on eBay, because all those eBay vintage prices get a little bit on my nerves. And then 10 euros there, 10 euros there, stuff quickly accumulates. So yeah, I luckily get this in the drawer, because in our 386, we obviously had a 38680 keyboard, and I have the feeling we don't have this anymore. It felt a little bit like IBM keyboard. I wonder if we still, but I have not seen it in my parents' house basement or attic when I was looking for vintage stuff. So no idea where this 38680 keyboard went to. And yeah, 80, the adapter never. Yeah, as I said, accidentally had it. Also, I have 2 or 3 of those adapters. So this is a new adapter that came with the keyboard. By the way, it doesn't plug in nicely. It plugs in like, you know, this cheap, like not very accurately manufactured, cheap Chinese no name feel. Like it really scratches, not very nice. Maybe I check my other adapters if one of those is nicer. And also, fun here, the other 2 or 3 adapters that I have in my adapter box, I for sure also never have used. So all the USB keyboards back in the day, 10 years ago, 20, 15 years ago, always when I got this adapter, I put it in an adapter box, never used this, and only now, even a decade later, for these YouTube videos, I have a use for them. So yeah, these are the adapters. And I hope you enjoyed this video and live stream. And I hope you learned something new, which is, okay, let's plug it in there. And yeah, maybe let me know in the comments below what you like and dislike. I think there is no point to stream here another hour and stream here trying all the register bit combinations there. I think that is a little bit too boring and not very interesting, not even for me. I wish this linear addressing mode would just work. It is also for me a little bit annoying that it doesn't just work. Although I tried and errored already 2 hours with this before the live stream. And the Logitech bundled piece 2 adapters were okay. By the way, as we still have 12 people, I can get my adapter box and try this other adapters now. 1 second. So my precious adapter box of 2 various random adapters, like Unix, AUI, Ethernet stuff, and serial and parallel. So we have here probably, what is this by the way? Oh, some USB OTG and fun stuff like this. So here is actually, I have the reverse one for sure. This I also never used, AT2, PS2, fun stuff, for sure never used. So, here is one of these. Some serial null modem gender changer. Stuff like this. And US. From my, probably, maybe from my very first iPhone that I brought in the US. Before it was on sale in Germany. So do I have only one of those here? Then let's see if this one is nicer. Does this make a nicer scratching sound? Only a little bit. Yeah, but I think this feels slightly nicer. But it has a mouse icon, funny enough. Only real is mouse icon, but I think this should work for both. I don't think it has a different wiring for mouses, or did it? Can, by the way, does this plug nicer into the 80 connector? Because this plugs also way nicer. This one is extremely hard to plug in there. Feels like breaking it off, actually. Let's see if this mouse adapter works also. Then I put this new one in there. And now everything is full already here with everything. Let's see if the mouse adapter. But this is for sure only decoration. The mouse. I don't think the wiring for mouse is different. Yeah, Marco Becker writes mouse. Let's see. But I think Numlock works. This would not work if this is would be different, but yeah, as expected, just works with the mouse symbol on the plastic. No problem, no worries there. So yeah, thank you very much for tuning in here, for enjoying this vintage tinkering with me. I hope I get this working soon, either with the 64K memory for the acceleration for a start, and then later with this linear addressing also. That would be more efficient for the frame buffer access. Don't forget to share, like, and subscribe. Hope to see you soon for the next videos to come, and have a good day or night, and see you next time.